So we're back on the van. I did an ABS sensor on the rear, lasted 2 days, and then the lights come back on again. Yeah, ABS light. Yeah, look, there we go, same code. I think this is going to be a wiring problem. So this is the old sensor out. It's hard to make out, but you can just see that it's corroded. The tip actually came off. So quite happy that the sensor's no good. Obviously that snapped there, which, looking at the state of it, it's obviously been broke for a while. So probably cracked and let water in, and it corroded the end out. I'm going to take the wheel arch liner out. It's held on by these little screws here. There's two there. There's one here, there's one up there. And then I think there's a bolt there and a clip. Might be two clips at the back, but I'll get this out because the wiring goes from the ABS sensor. It goes forward and then it goes across and then it comes out, or it comes up behind this rear light. So if we take the light out, I think we can access it there, and they join it because the cable's got like a PVC sheath on it, and then it changes to just a normal braided loom. I think that's where the problem is, and it's round here somewhere. I think it might even be lower down, but you have to yank it all out to get to it. Normal T5 crimp connector things that corrode. So I'm going to take that apart and have a look. Right there. Two screws there. Screw there. And screw up here. There's a captive nut. Well, there's a captive nut washer thing that goes there. A bolt that goes in there. So we've got to unclip the ABS sensor, unclip the brake wear sensor. And then there's two clips on the arm there. There's another one behind this pipe here. Obviously on a transport, you'll see that easy. And then these clips here, which just pull off. And then that one there is a plastic one. So use a tool to get that one off. That's the beauty of having the wheel arch liner out. You can just see it. But yeah, caravel, so we've got extra pipes. The rear AC and heater. I don't know if this is going to come out, but there's a grommet right there. See it? I've put a bit of spray on it just to make it easier to get out. That's got to come out. And then we've got to poke it back up in the hole to get the loom out. To get this rear light off, there's two Phillips screws on there, one there, and then push it that way. See? Just tap it off because there's two slots that locate on these two pins, and then to put it back on again, just push it forward and then to the side, and then do your screws up, the light off, that's our loom. I'm going to pull that grommet up because that's where the wiring harness is going to come through. We'll be able to get in there, reach through and grab it, and then pull it out of this hole here, but don't pull it all the way back, leave some in there so it's easier to pull it back through, because we obviously we don't have to try and fight through there because it's got a 90 degree at the bottom to get through. You can take this trim off, and it's these type of fixings. If I can find the other one, there you go, it's these type of fixings. You just pull the center up and then you pull the whole thing out, and when you're putting it back in again, you just push that in, same as when you're putting this back in. You can just pop that in, wiggle it in, and then give it a bit of a push with the butt of a screwdriver. If they don't go in easy, a little tap. Yeah, it's not pretty state of this. What they've done, bizarrely enough, is cut the wire, put a connector in, but then left the rubbish join. So if you look at this one, this is for the brake pad sensor. That's a metal connector, that red looking thing in the middle there. There you go, see that? That's a red, That's a metal connector, that red thing there, and it just breaks. And that's exactly what happened with this. But yeah, they left the rubbish connector. Imagine that was joined there. And then put a second connector in without chopping the wire out. So what I've done is I've cut it right back to here. This is mine here, and I've retwisted them because these are actually twisted together. So that's the black wire. This is the brown one. I've added a section of pink. That's my solder join there. I've got a bit of heat shrink here where the wire was nicked. So I've just put a bit of heat shrink on there. So that's not another join. It just goes from there to there. So chop that section out. I'm going to do the, obviously I've checked the wear sensors while we're here, and just as well, because that's the problem. So that one will probably be the same. So I'll try and open that one up and have a look. But I'm going to repair that, retape it, and then we'll put it back together. There you go. So that's what it's supposed to look like. You can see the copper, but that silver bit there, they're the same thing, same state of it. So yeah, 3 out of 4 failed. Right, I'm gonna I'll cut this one out anyway, repair that. I'm going to solder them together. I've done a video on soldering. If you want to watch that, I'll put a link up here. And I've done one on chopping into a wiring loom. Same thing again. I'll put that there. I'll bring you back when this is kind of repaired. That one, I'm going to have to chase this back. So I might have to remove this grommet and come back up here. I don't really want to do that. I want to stay this side of the grommet if I can. But this wire is so corroded, it may make soldering it quite hard, because it's actually black. So I don't think I'll be able to clean that up to get a decent joint on it. I will remove as much as that as I can. But I'll bring you back when I've done that bit. Got this one soldered. I'd keep chasing the wire back because it was so corroded until I could get to some good copper. I've had to come right back here. But I'm running out of space. So luckily, I managed to find a good bit of copper there that I can now shrink up. I've chopped loads of this out. Keep chasing it back till you find a decent copper. Even then, this one's a little bit suspect, but it's as far as I can go without going the other side of this grommet. But it's soldered up all right, so it should be fine. I'm going to take this up now, and then I'm going to get rid of that mess while I'm here. No point in leaving that rubbish there, these things. That's the loom taped up and eaten up the tow bar wiring. Because that was just a dog's breakfast. Now we've got to poke this back down, because this is the grommet that we got out right from the bottom. So I'll poke this back down and get that all in. Remember this grommet. Managed to get it back in. Luckily I sprayed it with some oil. It's tricky but not impossible. Now this loom clips back in here. Just basically reversal of removal. Some of these have seen better days, but that's what it is, I suppose. And just clip up there. Remember, there's one up behind here. A little clip. Put some oil on it. And my hook. There's my hook. Oh, there's a little clip one that's. Back in there, fiddly. I'll give it that. See, this is a caravel, so we've got all these heater pipes, which make it so much easier. Right, and then I'm going to run it along there back onto the sensors. There you go, all the clips back on. You just have to push the bottom of it and then latch it round and make sure there's no muck in it, because it'll fill up with dirt and all sorts of muck. But that's back on there. We're getting out. Now before we put all this wheel arch liner in, back up, I'm just going to stick the wheel on, check the codes, and more importantly check the live data. Let's see how we're doing. I'm only going to stick two bolts in and I'm not going to do it up massively tight. Literally, it's just so give me something to spin. And then we have to take it off to put the wheel arch liner in. Just like that. A little bit wobbly, but should be fine. Right, let's check the codes. That's what we want to see. Right, the light's off on our 6 ignition, so I'm fairly confident. There we go, brilliant. More importantly, let's have a look at the measuring blocks. Group 1, that's the one we're interested in. Want to be able to see some movement. There we go. We got there in the end. Now we know we fix this thing. Wheel arch liner back in. These are a little bit of a fight getting out. I didn't record it. Let's put it around the right way, shall we? Right, ignore that first bit. Now we know the ABS light's out. We can put this wheel arch liner back in. I didn't record taking it out. It's a bit of a fight. There's only a couple of screws, I'll show you where they are. But literally, this is going to fall out now, isn't it? It sits in there like that. There's a nut there. One of my fixings is broke, obviously. And we've got a little flap at the front, which goes in between. There's an under tray. Flap goes in there. There's a stud sticking out there. And then what we've got, let me get you over here. So we've got a bolt that goes in there. There's a captive nut. Where are we? There's a captive nut washer thing that goes there. Screw there. And screw up here. Two screws there. And literally the last one is up around here somewhere. There it is, right there. I've had to put a captive nut in there because I broke mine. I'm just going to do that up, get the wheel on, and that's good to go. Hopefully I've covered everything. I did this in a bit of a funny order because I got a bit involved in it, but hopefully this one's helped you out. Check out my other one on the ABS sensor. I'll see you on the next one.